Thank you for joining me for this slow art experience. I'm going to guide you in a simple looking exercise that focuses on a painting by the artist Kehinde Wiley from the collection of the St. Louis Art Museum. To begin, assume a comfortable position. If you'd like, close your eyes and concentrate on your breathing. Take in a deep breath through your nose, and breathe out through your mouth. And again, take a deep breath in and let it out. Last time, breathe in and slowly breathe out. Now, open your eyes as your breathing finds its own natural pace and explore this entire image. As you look, slowly and carefully, notice the areas that first capture your attention. Think about what drew your eyes to those areas. Consider the colors in this painting. How would you describe them? What about the shapes that fill the canvas? Are they angular or curved? Symmetrical or asymmetrical? In person, this painting is very large. It's about 8 feet tall and 6 feet wide. How does that knowledge affect your perception of it? Why might the artist have painted this portrait so large? Now, take note of how the figure in the center is posed. What might this posture signal to the viewer? This is a portrait of St. Louisan Ashley Cooper. In preparing to paint this work, the artist requested that Ashley assume a pose imitating that of King Charles I of England, as he is seen in a 17th century painting by Dutch artist Daniel Maitens that is also in the museum's collection. Let's take a closer look. Notice her direct gaze. She's looking right at you, the viewer of the painting. What does her facial expression convey to you? What might she be feeling or thinking? As you continue to look, notice the detail with which the artist depicted her clothing and accessories. Her necklace, the band on her left wrist, her ring, her dress, the studs on her sandals, and the polish on her toenails. Now, observe how the flowers and vines seem to interact with her. Known for incorporating heavily patterned backgrounds that are inspired by, or direct copies of, historic textiles, wallpapers, and other sources into his portraits, the florals and foliage Wiley uses in this painting are drawn from a Russian textile. Instead of merely providing a background, flowering green vines curl around Ashley's legs and torso as if they've come to life. A ring of vibrant flowers hovers behind her head as a sort of halo. According to the artist, it's almost as though the backgrounds were demanding to be represented as well. Their competition for the picture plane exists in direct relationship with my insistence upon the black body being in the forefront within a museum space. That sense that I deserve to be here, that constant fight for presence. Wiley uses portraiture to address exclusion, in particular the lack of depictions of black individuals in historical art of Europe and the United States. Of his portraits, he said, "It's also about drawing attention to a very real, lived present, to people who are oftentimes ignored, people who are diminished into two-dimensional caricatures. I wanted to be able to treat them with the same loving hand, with the same attention to detail that was devoted to some of the most powerful people in European history." Now, bring your focus back to your breathing. Thank yourself for taking the time to explore this work of art. As you go through your day, be mindful of the fullness of what you observe, including both what is present and what is missing. Thank you for joining me for this slow art experience.